Come, let us shout praises to God. Raise the roof for the rock who saved us. Let's march into his presence singing praises, lifting the rafters with our hymns. And why? Because God is the best. High King over all gods. In one hand, he holds the deep caves and caverns. In the other hand, he grasps the high mountains. He made oceans. He owns it. His hands sculpted earth. So come, let us worship. Bow down before him, on your knees before God who made us. Oh yes, he is our God, and we're the people of his pasture, the flock of the he feeds. Drop everything and listen. Listen as he speaks. Don't turn a deaf ear as in the bitter uprising. As on the day of the wilderness test, when your ancestors turned and put me to the test. For 40 years, they watched me as at work among them, as over and over they tried my patience, and I was provoked. Oh, was I provoked? Can't they keep their minds on God for 5 minutes? Do they simply refuse to walk down my road? Exasperated, I exploded. They'll never get where they're heading. Never be able to sit down and rest. We come to worship in this place, to worship as his people, his church. Yet as we enter, we come as if it is just like any other day of the week. We come at times with little excitement, with little desire. We come out of obligation or out of duty, yet we come to worship the God of creation, the God of our salvation, the God who took us out of the desert and from where we wandered in sin. But we often struggle to stay awake. Or we spend much of our time thinking about what's going on around us. What's going on in the world about us. What's going on in our lives. And he asks us to come. Come, let us shout praises to God. Raise the roof for the rock who saved us. Let us march into his presence, singing praises, lifting the rafters with our hymns, as the psalmist writes. Is this what you thought of as you were winding off this morning? Is this what you thought of as your wife woke you up or your husband woke you up? Is this what you thought of as your parents woke you up? We may not really want to share what went through our minds at the moment that our alarm went off. In fact, some of us might even be embarrassed to share what crossed our minds as we thought it's time to get up and go to church. Or as that alarm went on this morning and you thought, oh, it is so early. How can I possibly get up this morning and go into a time of worship? Were you thinking, come, let us worship, let us bow down before him, let us lift our voices with praise, let us sing hymns, lift off the rafters of this old building. As you came here, were you thinking, let's get going to our best part of the day, to the best part of our week. Let us lift the roof off of the building. Let us sing praises so the world hears the praises of his people. The praises of his people for their God and of their salvation. As you came here, did you come with purpose? As a soldier marching into battle to face the enemy. The Scottish regiments have a great tradition. As they go into battle, they have pipers. And some people hate the bagpipes because they think they sound horrible. But for the Scottish regiment, it's what calls them into battle. And as the piper gets out in front and begins to play his music, his pipes, music on the tunes on his pipes, regimental tunes and songs of victory, about it. In fact, even into the Second World War, there were still pipers, even with machine guns, who would lead the soldiers into battle, playing the bagpipes with purpose. In fact, at one point, the German soldiers were called the men of the Highland regiments, the ladies of hell, because they wore their kilts, because they were so terrifying as they marched into battle with purpose. Fearless men. This courage would make many an enemy force talk about them. As we enter into this place of worship, let us march into His presence singing praises. Let us have some purpose as we come into here this morning. I think of the song of victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. Or crown Him with many crowns, the Lord upon His throne. How often have we come in and we say, oh, victory in Jesus. Or crown Him with many crowns. So, that was one of my favorite hymns. How they changed it a little bit. It's a pretty song. How they changed it. And think about who we are singing about. Victory in Jesus. Crown Him with many crowns. How great Thou art. When we enter into worship, we should come with a purpose like that of a soldier entering into battle. We should lift our praises to God so the enemy knows without a doubt who it is we serve, and the gates of hell will tremble. But why? Well, in the scripture that we're looking at, verse 3 to 5, it says, and why? Because the Lord God is the best. I love that the way the message says that. God is the best. Why do we worship? Because God is the best. High King over all gods. In one hand, He holds the deep caverns and the caves. In the other hand, He grasps the high mountains. He made the oceans. He owns it. His hands sculpted the earth. I don't know if you've ever had the opportunity to go into the caves or in the world, anywhere around the world, when you're down in the caverns of in Carlsbad caverns, you see these mountainous things in there, the beauty of underneath. Or we went into even a small cave, you crawl through a gap, maybe this big, just barely get your body through, and you open it, it opens into this great cavern, and the stalactites, and all the other great formations that you see in there. God has created, and you cannot but help but worship who He is. So simple, because God is the best. When we enter into this place, lifting our praises, we come with the knowledge that there is no other God like our God. Not one God of this world compares to our God. No one has a hand that holds the deep caverns or the caves. Or in the other hand, the mountains. No one in this world can say that they created the oceans or formed the mountains. No one. Who is our God? Why do we worship? Very simply, that is the God we worship. That is who I got up early this morning to meet here today. So why do we find it so hard to worship Him? Best. When you look at the wonders around the world, not even the seven wonders of the world, just the wonders of the world, the mountains that He created, the fact that that mountain goat wandered along the edge of that cliff, or that man hanging from tree to tree. And I thought when I first saw it, when you first look at it, it's just maybe little trees, but then it's hundreds of feet above the earth, and jumping into that cavern, it's just amazing. The God that we worship is a God who can change the world like that, who can form the world. So come, let us worship before Him. On your knees before God who made us. I call upon those who have met Jesus to let go and pull from holding back and worship Him. For he loves you with a love that is unconditional, a love that is unsurpassable, a love that is deeper than the cavern the man jumped into, a love that is higher than any mountain that we saw pictured there, a love that sent his son into the world. Oh yes, he is our God, and we are his people of his pasture, and the flocks he feeds. Drop everything and listen. Listen as he speaks. What is easy to miss is that in worship, it's not just a one-way conversation for us lifting our praises to him and singing our songs to him. It is also God speaking into our lives as we hear from his word, as we hear how from the songs that we sing and the prayers that we hear lifted to him. We come here to encounter God. He is not a silent. As a shepherd calls out to his sheep, God calls out to you today. He wants you to hear his voice as he comes to meet you here in this building that we have gathered. Oh, it's true, we can meet him out in the wilderness as we've seen there. But one thing we must do, we must listen for him as he listens for us. Passage of scripture we read in there says, drop everything, listen as he speaks. Cast all of the clutter away in your life. Don't turn a deaf ear as in the bitter uprising. As on the day of the wilderness test, when your ancestors turned and put me to the test. For 40 years they watched me at work among them, as over and over they tried my patience, as I was provoked, was I provoked. Can't they keep their minds on God for 5 minutes? Would that be the same that we have too? We have seen God at work all around us, in our lives, in creation. But are we as guilty as these people of Israel? Are we easily distracted by the desire to sleep or hunger or by the disappointments of life? Have you closed your ears so you cannot hear him speak to you? Wake up. God wants to speak to you. He wants to show you the love he has for his children. Wake up. He wants to see what you think of him. Wake up. God claims the earth and everything in it. God claims the world and all who live in it. He built it on the ocean's foundations. He laid it out on the river's girders. Who can climb the mountain of God? Who can scale the holy north face? Only the clean-handed, only the pure-hearted, men who won't cheat, women who won't seduce. God is at their side. With God, they help. With God's help, they make it. This, Jacob, is what happened to God's seekers and God questers. Wake up, you sleepy-headed city. Wake up, you sleepy-headed people. King of glory is ready to enter. Who is the King of glory? God, armed and battle-ready. Wake up, you sleepy-headed city. Wake up, you sleepy-headed people. The King of glory is ready to enter in. Who is this King of glory? God of the angel armies. He is the King of glory. A passage from Psalm chapter 24, verses 1 through 10. See, God is ready to enter into our lives. Are you ready to let him enter? See, worship as a church is making it a highlight of the week. It is the day I can put God where he should be. It is the day where I can turn my whole attention toward him. But can we keep our minds open for at least 5 minutes? Proverbs 3, 1 through 9 says, good friend, don't forget all I've taught you. Take to heart my commandments. They'll help you live a long, long time. A long life lived, full and well. Don't lose grip on love and loyalty. Tie them around your neck. Carve their initials on your heart. Earn a reputation for living well in God's eyes and the eyes of the people. Trust God from the bottom of your heart. Don't try to figure out everything on your own. Listen for God's voice in everything you do. Everywhere you go, he is the one who will keep you on track. Don't assume know it all. Run to God. Run from evil. Your body will glow with health. Your very bones will vibrate with life. Now listen, honor God with everything you own. Give Him the first and the best. This is what truly worship is as a church. When we come here this morning, and every week after that, and other days and opportunities we have to come in corporate worship, it is coming to give God our best, turning over to Him everything in our lives, giving Him our heart, our mind, and our strength. Love the Lord your God. Show Him the worship that is to do His name. Give Him the opportunity to hear your heart. And also listen for what He wants to tell to you. Wake up, people. Hear from